Hey guys, what's going on? So it's been a little bit of time since the last GTO update. No, it really hasn't. It's been about a week. Anyway, here's another one. this time, I've actually gotten a decent amount of stuff done, though. As of right now, I have all of the metal patches done, as far as major ones. I have a couple of little bitty ones to do that are, you know, about 3 square inches. But I have all of my large metal work done. All of the skinning is done. And as far as that goes, I even welded this panel in back here that I was kind of having a problem with. But as of right now, this is in there. It's welded. I haven't cleaned the welds up. I haven't seam sealed anything. But it is in there. The track is in there. And as you can see, I have my old glass in there, which I'm not going to be using that. I'm going to buy all new glass, at least for the front and the back. But I threw it in there just to kind of for mock-up to make sure it still fits. Yeah, it fits well. There's plenty of room around it for the butyl and, you know, sealer. I also have my trim laying in there, and it's kind of haphazardly taped down right now. But I do have all my trim. It's got one little kind of hitch in it over here. I'll be able to fix that, though. I can actually just push down on it with my fingers, and it goes away. So it's not very substantial. I think even just putting it on the trim clips, and it would probably solve that problem. But it all lines up. I'm happy with it. Like I mentioned in the last video, I built a new package tray for the car out of sheet metal. And I'm really happy with that. It has two to three layers of sound deadener, like Dynamat, on it. And I'm happy with how that turned out. So, considering like a month ago, the trunk was not even in there anymore. That was gone. I had the package tray chopped out. The back glass was out. I could, if it weren't for this little bitty, you know, piece of metal here, I would have been able to walk all the way into my car to where the back seats were and until my chest actually touched something structural. So this is a lot better. And I feel a lot better about the car overall now that all of this metal work is done. It's kind of a relief. I don't think I can run into much else rust at this point. I've found all of it that I think I'm gonna even be able to find. So all I had to do was replace 90% of the car with new metal, and it's good to go. OPG should be really happy with me. They've gotten too much business. For something that's actually fun that I've been enjoying doing for the last couple days, other than doing AN lines, I hate that. I've been mentioning getting that fuel cell, and I finally bought it. I bought a 20-gallon RCI fuel cell. I went with the 20-gallon fuel cell because, one, I like fuel cells, and two, 20 gallons is actually the same size as the original factory gas tank would have been in this car. They came with big gas tanks, which I think is really cool. But there's not really like any benefit size-wise, obviously, since it is the same, but the fact that it actually has two outlets on the bottom is a big deal, because I intend to run, at some point, two electric pumps, one off of this side and one off of that side. So that's really one of the only main benefits. The other reason is I really do just like them. I think they're cool. I like that from behind me at a stoplight, you'll be able to look under the car and see a giant red fuel cell hanging below it. I think that there's a kind of an aesthetic factor to that that's neat. As far as the top of the fuel cell goes, you can see that I have one line inlet capped on that side. And over here, this is just a vent tube. What I did there was, off of that little AN coming off, I did a 90, and then it's barbed. And this is like a dash 8 equivalent hose. I could have actually used a inline for this, but it's more trouble than it was really worth, considering that this doesn't really do anything except let vapor out and let air in so it doesn't collapse the tank whenever it draws on it. But I went from that barbed to the actual hose, and then I went to another barb fitting here, and then that fitting is onto an AN bulkhead that I drilled the trunk pan and put that bulkhead in. And then on the bottom of that, there will be an actual filter. They're kind of funny looking. It looks like a little baby can and air filter for like a throttle body unit or something. They're itty bitty, but he didn't actually have any in today. I got that assembly at Pat's today.
Performance Parts Plus.
Performance Parts Plus. You hear us talk about them a lot. That's where I get nitrous for the Trans Am too. But yeah, I got it. He didn't have that. He said he'd order some, so I'll have one by Monday. But if you look at the top of the tank again, there is also a sending unit for a fuel gauge. It's a typical 90 ohm sending unit, so I can use any run-of-the-mill Chevy style fuel gauge. Nothing particularly special about it, but just it being on there is good because a lot of fuel cells don't have them. I was looking at a Jazz fuel cell that was 16 gallons, so smaller than this, and it didn't have one, and it was the same price. So I went ahead and got this one just because of that. It's really annoying having to open your trunk, twist that out, and shine a flashlight in there just to see how much gas you have left. It's very frustrating. As far as this goes too, there is actually room here because on GTOs the plate flips down and the fuel filler neck is right there. With it recessed in the trunk so far, I'll actually be able to kind of buy a little 90 or 45 or whatever is going to line up. It'll bolt here and then I'll run a big clear hose to that, and then I'll end up putting a filler neck on the outside of the car where the factory one would have been. So I'm not going to actually have to open my trunk to put gas in the car, although it probably will be like this for a year or better because I know how I am. But that is the plan, to have it actually go here with a nice threaded one. If you look under the car, again, you'll notice that it comes out with a 90, and then there's a little bit of A in line, and then it goes to 100 micron filter here. This will kind of sift out some of the big stuff that might get in the tank. And then it goes to more A in line, and then there's about, I don't even know, probably 14, 15 feet going to the front of the car, all tucked nice up in the frame rail when I'm done. Right now it's just held on with some zip ties, but I'm going to actually use some P-clips to fully install it, which I do have right here. Mm-hmm. But going from that, there's A in line all the way to the front, and then at the front it goes to obviously the fuel pump, which I have a nice Edelbrock fuel pump. It's good for about 600 horsepower, so it's good to go for right now. But this is the stainless braided line. It goes in and then it comes out here to black braided line, and then there's another 40 micron filter there, and then it goes to my gauge and then into the carb. So it's probably a little elaborate for what it has going on right now, but I'm obviously planning on building another engine. Probably end up doing some form of Butler stroker kit, lots of nitrous, something.
And it's cool with the dual outlets back there, because eventually this thing's probably going to have dual electric pumps, nitrous, turbo.
Yeah, that's my plan.
Do you want to show them how you did the little cage under there out of the square tube?
Or? Oh, yeah. I forgot. What I wound up doing to actually hold the fuel cell in was I welded these box tubes in to the actual inside of the frame rail. And then I came down off of it right here. And then there's little tabs on the actual fuel cell itself. So what I did was those line up with those tabs, and now there's big fat bands that run back and forth across the bottom of the tank that actually hold it in.
Yeah, like flat plate, basically.
Yeah, like a big, flat, thick piece of plate. So it's actually getting all of its support on these big plates, but it's pulling down on this, which is welded to the actual frame of the car. Mm-hmm. So this is very sturdy. It's not going anywhere. And I'm really happy with how it turned out.
Right now, this is temporarily hung with some tape, but he's going to obviously make like a bracket to hold that to that.
What my plan is right here, this bolt, because I actually welded nuts into this box tube when I was doing it and then cleaned it up, because obviously you can't thread a square. But I welded those nuts in, cleaned it up, so the bolt goes straight in and then it threads into this tube. So I'm going to basically build a bracket that comes off and then hugs this and holds it there perfectly steady. And then, like I said, I'll eventually get around to P-clipping the fuel line all the way up the frame, and I'm probably going to do that tomorrow. I don't like leaving stuff like 3/4 finished.
Do we want to see if it runs?
Oh, it'll run.
And I could also check the fuel pressure up there on the gauge to show that it's pumping.
Yeah, it'll run. I have faith in it. Probably run better if I
hook
my battery up.
Yeah. It's cold in here, too. I don't know if you can see our breath, but it's pretty chilly.
I did buy a painless wiring kit. It's a brand new fuse panel. All I have to do is unhook and rehook to the new one, and then I can come off of it with my new accessories and stuff, too. So I have everything that I need to actually wire this car completely now, mm-hmm. too. And that'll be next. Because right now, mechanical, pretty far along.
I said you would run, so let's not disappoint me.
Hey, fired right up, and it was actually drawing through the fuel tank.
So yeah, the fuel pressure looked good, just like a tick over six, which that'll work.
That's
where
I wanted. It's fine. Yeah, hey, good to go. Yeah, tick over six. That's pretty good. You guys notice this? I have a parachute latch on here that says before flight.
Yeah.
I bought that more as a lanyard, but
the bumper is hung custom with some tape.
I saw one of you said to throw away the 69 bumper and buy a 68 bumper. I just want you to know that I'm absolutely not going to do that. I like this way more, so I'm doing this instead.
Unless you have a brand new Chrome 68, think about it if you want to mail it to us.
I really would.
No. Yeah. He likes the 69 better, and I do too, actually.
I'm sorry if you have a 68. It's not ugly. It looks fine. It's cool. My personal opinion is that I like this more. I'm not going to 69 clone this, though. I'm not going to put the different valence on it and all that. I do just like this more. My lord, is it a gas chamber in here right now.
Yeah, we got it all sealed up, and it hadn't been run for a while, so. Ooh,
got the door closed and everything. All right, guys. Well, I guess that'll about do it. Like I said, really happy with the amount of progress that I've made lately. The fuel cell is pretty much completely done. I have to make some brackets, P-clip it. And all of my major metal work on the car is also done. My skinning is done. So I basically have regular body work and wiring. And I'm good to go. I get some glass and drive down the road. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching and commenting. And we'll see you in the next one. Bye.